Let me put on a live chat real quick. Yeah, I think, okay, let me see. Yep, everything's a go. It's a beautiful day in my neighborhood. It's a beautiful day in my neighborhood. Everything's fine. Getting better with time. What's good, family? Come on through. It's 10:27 in the morning, Hawaii time. How are you? Come on in here. Come through. How you doing? I hope everything is going your guys' way. Let me see who the chicken talking about. What's going on? Come in here. It's a beautiful day in my neighborhood. It's a beautiful day in my neighborhood. How you guys doing? Gonna go eat breakfast at the country kitchen like last weekend. Cause it's family fun day weekend. Okay? My thing. How everything going for you and Shondell? I love y'all. I'm grateful for all y'all, all the true ones. And as always, I send y'all great love, strength, endurance, and great power for you to get through this bullshit. But it's going though. It's going. We getting to it. We getting to it. Oh, they're having a car wash over here today. There must be a fundraiser. Must be a fundraiser going down. They having a car wash. They having a car wash. What's good, Unique Waters? Yeah, I love y'all so much. Thank y'all for loving me and keeping it true. Okay? I appreciate that, because, you know, Lord would be loyal to the wrong things and fumbling their blessing. How you fumble God, bro? These motherfuckers be fumbling God. What's wrong with y'all? Day, ain't it? Let me tell y'all something, man. Jupiter, the beginning of her live stream this morning. Look at this mountain. Look at the mountain. Oh, look at what's above the mountain. Come on out here. Come on, show yourself, ancestor. Show yourself. But what was I saying? Drea was like, the weather. She said, is it raining where you are? Because the rain here, the weather here, then delayed my shipments for her business. I told that bitch. That's the first thing he said today. The weather here then delayed my shipments. Girl, you playing with God. I told y'all the ops life is just gonna get worse and worse and worse. They think every time they go out and do something that it look to them like they progressing, they really digressing. Okay, they're not progressing, they're digressing, and they think that everything is clear. I told you, they be thinking everything okay. They think they can pop back out and do something else, and then they just get slapped. They get slapped into the oblivion again. Gotta start all over. You gotta start all over. Told you Dre don't play. They told me I wasn't powerful. Meanwhile, I'm controlling the weather that they said the good government was doing. And it's delaying they businesses that I told them that I was gonna take from them. I told that bitch that I was gonna take her business from her, everything. I told her her life is gonna be total dismay. And destruction. Every time she look around, think everything's clear, boom, she go get hit again, bitch. You getting dragged, ho. All the ops is. So she's like, the weather is delaying my shipments for my business. So guys, just hang in there. Dreddy don't play, goddammit. They tried to play me. Talk about I ain't God saying these other motherfuckers is the great mother trying to sit in our places. They finna, whew, they in trouble. Yeah, I know they is. You know, I know they. You know, I know. Keep on working, my G. You know, I know. Yes. Yep, my, that's all you can do. You know I know, my G. Keep doing your thing, okay? Keep on flexing on them, okay? Flex. Keep on flexing on them. Yes. Keep on flexing on them. They got to pay, and you got to have a front row seat, okay? You get to have a front row seat, okay? Fuck they thought. You know what I seen? Somewhere in Oklahoma, they are preparing for the eclipse. They got the, they got 150 state troopers that's coming out, and they activated the National Guard for the eclipse that's coming up next month. When you, right after you do your interview, my G, for Unsung on BET, Miss NYC. Listen, they know the Great Mother coming, bro. They getting ready, cause they know what I told you. It's gonna be cannon blasts everywhere when the Great Mother pop out. They the military them been activated for the eclipse, cause they don't know. They know that it's time for her to show herself. They know it's time for her to show herself, right? They know it's time for me and my wife to take over and sit on our thrones. And they figure, oh, it's gotta be the eclipse, so they all get in position, bro. Yeah, they show. Didn't they have fun? Didn't they? Didn't they have fun while the suffering was going on? They thought the shit was funny. It was all, they was acting funny in your face, doing shit behind your back. Yeah, that's, look, black. Ain't that something? Ain't that something? Finna be a blackout. And that's the, it's right before. Ain't that something? It's right before the National Guard and got activated for the eclipse. I love you, my G, man. Keep on stepping, okay? You and Shondell, keep on stepping and flexing, okay? Y'all deserve this. Yes. Like Bob said, he who wins, he who laughs last is he who wins. And we about to be laughing all the way to the motherfucking bank, okay? Stupid motherfuckers. And they gotta watch and suffer. I'm telling y'all, do not help these motherfuckers. Do not help them. When you see them struggling and hungry and homeless, do not help them, okay? They deserve this shit. They deserve it. Some of it is gonna be gruesome. It's gonna kind of pull at some of y'all heartstrings, because y'all some good. Y'all the true ones. Y'all got beautiful hearts. So, but don't let that shit get in the way. Let them get this shit. They got to pay. They got to pay. They got to pay. They got to pay. Okay? Thank you, my G. I appreciate you for real. Because being true is truly rare, as you can see, man. I was over here trying to fix people and change their lives. You know, I was trying to help people be better. Doing shit for the free. Making it, and they was doing all kinds of shit, talking all kinds of shit behind my back, and they didn't think I would ever find out, bro. Yeah, they continue to not help them motherfuckers. Let them motherfuckers slip and slide down that razor slope, okay? Because that's what they deserve. That's what they manifested into their lives. Being assholes, being backbiters, being backstabbers, doing all kinds of underhanded shit behind our backs, thinking that they wasn't never gonna get that get back. But now it's time for the big payback, motherfuckers. It is here. The big payback is here, y'all. The big payback. All the true ones about to get their big payback and enjoy it. God has prepared a table in front of your enemies for you. Eat. And you have made your enemies your footstools. Step on their ass. Okay? Fuck them. Motherfuckers trying to twist the Bible. These pastors trying to twist the Bible up now. The fuck wrong with y'all? Y'all got it fucked up and y'all about to see. Y'all about to see. Y'all got it fucked up. That's why these pastors getting fucked up today. Shot, stabbed, robbed. Churches burning down left and right because of dread. Y'all got God fucked up. All you motherfuckers. All you so-called spiritual motherfuckers got God fucked up. All you religious motherfuckers got God fucked up. And you're all gone. Hey, bitch. What's good, Sister Faith? Oh, praise indeed. Ja, we love you, Sister Faith. Keep on getting blessed, baby. I finna go up here and catch this bus to go eat my my weekend breakfast with my wife at Country Kitchen. I'm gonna get me the French toast this time, but that waffle been calling me, and I'm either gonna get me a burger or omelet. I'm not sure. One of them, a burger or an omelet. Thank you. Somebody let me by, because I'm walking in the middle of the road. They let me pass. I stopped traffic. Hold on, I stopped traffic. There's a whole bunch of cars. They all stopped to let me cross the street. Ooh, look, here go another car wash. Some type of fundraiser going on today, y'all, for the kids, for the cakey. They got one at the mall, one at the movie theater. That's what's up. But yeah, I'm at the mall to go catch the bus. I'm so excited, y'all. I had a feeling Don was coming in next. Don in here. What's good, Sister Don? Yeah. I'm finna go have breakfast at the Country Kitchen again. I've been craving it. But this time I'm gonna give me a burger, but I'm gonna give me some French toast too. I don't know. I might give me an omelet. I'll see when I get there. I'm hungry as fuck though. I'm hungry. But I figure I'd go live with y'all because it's gonna be an hour before my bus come anyway. So I was like, I'll go live first because it's family fun weekend. And I wanna just check in with y'all and let y'all know that everything is still great with me, okay? I just had to deal with the fake ass family real quick and shake them out. Like you said, Sister Don, we gotta close the circle up. Everybody can't go. They thought everything was a go. They thought shit was sweet over here, my G. Swear to God. Swear to God, they thought I ain't know nothing they was doing. Swear to God, bro. They thought I ain't know shit. And I just been sitting patiently in the back, listening and watching. And I'm grateful, too, because some of y'all that came at me and let me know without letting me know what was up. You know, y'all wasn't snitching or nothing, but y'all was just like, you know, but you didn't say nothing. You said a whole bunch without saying much, okay? And I was like, yeah, we just gotta let this shit play out, man. Let it unfold, because like I told y'all, I give everybody a chance. Yeah, I give everybody a chance, fam. Everybody. I was even doing work for motherfuckers I knew was talking down to me, bro. Happy, you know, talking to them, being genuine with them still, even though they weren't being genuine with me. You know, I was teaching them a lesson. I told you, like, I'm a test. God uses me, the Great Mother, she uses me to test people. And I told people, don't test me. I'm the test, bro. The Great Mother purposely put me out here to test everyone, to test them. And they be fumbling God, bro. It's purposely fumbling God. Even if I went and worked into I worked their life in a good way. And they fumbled God, bro. That's the biggest L ever. To fumble God. Right at the end, when it's over, and you've been in God's presence. You know God and God knows you, like personally, like physically in the flesh, and you fumbled that blessing, bro. You fumbled the biggest blessing of your life, man. I used to feel bad, not no more. This ass whooping finna be something spectacular, yo. Cause the ones that knew who I was but still tried to play me finna get it the worst. They finna get it the worst, bro. You heard the car horn honk for confirmation? They finna get it the worst. The ones that purposely was fucking around, they finna get it the worst. And the craziest part about it is, guess who go give it to him? The Great Mother. My wife don't play about me. Y'all finna find out. My wife do not play about me. it's not even gonna be me, it's gonna be her. And I keep telling y'all, she way more powerful than me. It's frightening what she can do. It's frightening. It's frightening. You can't even pray this shit away. One of the readers was like, motherfuckers is praying, trying to pray you away. And they don't understand. You can't pray this down. Because, yeah, they did a lot. But I know who stole the hair, though. It's okay. A lot of people was playing in my... Yes, Miss NYC, let me tell you, they don't even know, bro. Let me tell you, man, it's gonna be a magnificent ass whooping. Like, they don't even see this shit coming, bro. They thought it was super sweet, bro. My wife, do not play about me at all, bro. She put me out here on purpose to test everybody. She did. And she knew I was strong enough to endure everything I was gonna go through. And I was supposed to know that she always had my back. And then I had my 24 elders around my throne and the Galactic Federation. So I wasn't put out here naked. Not at all. I could never be naked. It's too many. I keep warning these people, my protection is strong. The things I went through was on purpose to clear up karma from ancient times and to see if them motherfuckers could change too. But they did the same shit in ancient times. They just brought it to today. They brought that shit into today. I should have went and got me something to drink. Let me go to Times real quick, see if they got some coffee. Yeah, these motherfuckers stupid. But we still enjoying our lives, though. Like, all the shit I've been through made me stronger. I was already born strong. It just made me stronger. It gave me upgrades. And it helped me to bring the truth to the public. You know, and to for you guys to know that everything that y'all go through, too, is not in vain. And it's for me to be a support system to you all. And to actually be a warning sign for those of you who would come in my name and be a false prophet, be lying. I was here to do a lot of things and to help people evolve and spark their power within them and activate them and show them what they could do too if they keep going. That's why I went through a lot of this. To show you what you can do if you keep going and don't give up. I just had to activate y'all. And once I activated y'all, it was on the popping, bro. These motherfuckers been scared ever since. I give thanks for you all. Yeah, oh my God. My wife is so funny. She's like the coolest person on the planet. She is very laid back. She is hilarious. She is beautiful. She's everything, literally. She's everything they say that a great mother is, plus more. Like, she's everything plus more. I can't wait, bro. I can't wait for her to live and just to smile without having to hide her smile, because she's been hiding her smile since a young kid because traumatic things that's happened through her, to her and through her since ancient times. She's like, guys, because her smile attracts people to hurt her. She used to wear sunglasses a lot too. I used to be like, why are you always hiding them beautiful eyes? Them beautiful eyelashes. Why are you always hiding? Because it was her protection. She was protecting herself from people who come to steal her life. You know. So she was the first one wearing a mask. You know how people be wearing masks because of COVID? She was wearing a mask way before COVID started. She was wearing a mask back in 2012. Every, you know, 2013. She was already wearing masks, protecting her energy. Mm-hmm. People thought she was crazy. Nope. People over here. That's all that was. Oh my God. Sometimes it'd be so powerful we can't even look at each other. I just stepped into the store, so if the internet start acting funny, it's because I walked into the store. oh, look, the coffee machine is available from 5 to 10 a.m. They didn't turn it off. It's 10:47. I came to get some coffee. I didn't want to go to Starbucks. I'm not going to Starbucks now. The grocery store coffee machine is off. Damn, man. Let me just get a soda. Fuck it. Let me see. It's out of order. Okay, so what? See, that's a sign for my granddaddy. Look, he let me right down the water aisle. I was trying to somewhere else. Can y'all hear me? Because it went out because I went to the grocery store. Yeah, my granddaddy wanted me to drink some water. And I don't drink a lot of soda, but sometimes I like to smoke my cigarette and drink some like Sprite or like something real strong. I just like the way it make my tongue feel and drink some like Sprite or like something real strong. I just like the way it make my tongue feel, right? So soda machine was down. I looked up, was finna turn the other way, but my legs was walking straight, but I was about to turn. And I looked up where my legs had me walking, even though I was trying to turn. It was down the motherfucking water aisle. My granddaddy said, nigga, drink some water, bro. What you doing? If you don't drink this water, hold on, y'all. But yeah, we finna talk about it. Hold on. I'll wait for y'all to come back in. I'll wait for some of y'all to come back in because I see that. Let me see. The sun. I'm trying to see what y'all saying. It's the sun. Yeah, it's buffering. Let me know when y'all back. Because at one point it had started to peak. It was like 11 people in here. Then it went all the way back down again. It was a 96. Yeah, listen. My granddaddy, listen. He don't play. He said, I told you to drink some water. Everything in there was shut down that I was trying to go get. My legs walking forward. Meanwhile, I'm trying to turn, but my body wouldn't turn. My granddaddy's like, you better go down this water aisle. What the fuck wrong with you? Drink this water. And he's right. I drink water, but I drink a lot of coconut water, but they want me to drink H2O right now. It's something about drinking water right now that's important. Water. Not coconut water. Water. Something very important about drinking that right now. So I'm listening. Like, and if I wasn't listening, it's gonna make me do it anyway. So the fuck? I was like, why my legs won't turn? Oh, he done took over. But I told him they allowed to take over if they want to, because sometimes I don't be listening, bro. Yes, family, keep drinking. They got me drinking a lot of water, bro. But I know it's got to do with the spiritual warfare. So. Yeah, but let me tell y'all, sometimes, because y'all was talking about how we look at each other, sometimes the energy be so strong that we can't look at each other. Like, I mean, we can, but it be strong and we be wanting to have sex. For real. It be strong and it's like an energy that come out our eyes and we shock each other. I remember the first time I looked at my wife and she was looking directly at me. She was like, don't look. Yeah, sister, you need to drink that water. There's something about the water it has to do with spiritual warfare. They trying to dehydrate us. And not only that, we're upgrading and stuff is going on with our circuitry, our nervous system. So we got to drink a lot of water just because of the upgrades too going on with our circuitry. And you know, your nervous system is connected to your soul. So, water helps to moisturize your circuitry. And so like the signals that your soul is firing off to your nervous system, which goes all over your body, it's keeping it lubricated, and those pistons that's firing off, those energetic sparks that's firing off, are firing off more powerful just because of the water. So it's important. That's another reason, and it's the spiritual warfare. They're trying to drain us and dry us out. they're trying to dry us out too, so we gotta drink a lot of water. And the great mother, she is doing something to all the water. I done prayed a powerful prayer over the waters for us. It's an upgrade for our ops. It's a washout. They finna get washed the fuck out. They finna get spread out and washed. Like y'all seeing, they in the water. In a bad way. They in the water. Somebody else just drowned in the water. They slipped into a ravine. I haven't been posting what the shit I've been posting on my YouTube. I mean on my Facebook. I haven't been posting it on my YouTube. Yeah, they trying to dry us the fuck out and they mad, bro. They mad they can't, bro. Every day. Every motherfucking day. Every day. They trying their hardest, bro. And that shit, it ain't working. Okay, let me tell you about it. It ain't working. Okay. We got the whole true Holy Trinity behind us. Okay. Not behind us. Beside us. We walk together. Okay. They lift us up, too. They lift us up. Hold on a second. I'm trying to light my cigarette. The whole true Holy Trinity is walking right beside us. There's nothing they can do to stop this. We stopping they shit, though. We delaying them. They thought they was going to delay us. We playing in the delay. Okay, we playing in a major delay. All they shit getting delayed. They thought they was going to stop us. Y'all being stopped in your tracks, motherfuckers. Look at this banyan tree. Beautiful. I'm sitting underneath. They try to dry us the fuck out, y'all. Yeah, I thought that was me. Like, when people come up to me randomly and want to talk. Yeah, that's how my wife was. That's why she was wearing sunglasses. And then she stopped wearing sunglasses after she met me. Because I was like, I want to see your beautiful eyes. Why are you always wearing them? But she was doing it for protection. And then I knew why one day when this white dude named Frank, and his girlfriend, Frank used to have seizures all the time, right? I saved his life one day. He almost hit his head because I used to sell weed to him. He lived here on Kauai. He dead now, though. But he used to buy weed from me. He the reason why I got my first iPhone, matter of fact, because he traded me weed for an iPhone. So I was selling him weed one day, and he was talking to me and his girlfriend, his baby mama, in fact, because they weren't dating no more. But his baby mom came up to me and she started looking all up in my eyes like this, like, oh, yeah, and she's trying to drain me. I was like, bitch. Then it clicked, like, oh, this is why my wife wears sunglasses. These motherfuckers is trying to tap into our soul energy through our eyes and get a piece of it, bro. Get a piece of that wealth. These motherfuckers was coming out of everywhere, bro. They was coming out of everywhere towards me trying to steal my wealth. Everybody, bro, not just Jay-Z and Diddy and all them. It was so many people, bro. This shit was crazy. And it didn't help though. I'd be walking around in my dreams asking people if they want some money, and then I'd be like, psych. Like, I be fucking with the ops. Listen, I be fucking with the ops in my dreams. Like I did Quatita. I was like, I put my leg up at the gate she was trying to come up to. I was like, you need some money? You want some money? She just looked at me, and I had all this money. I was like, you want some money? I was finna slap her in the face with some money and walk away. I was gonna slap her ass down them steps with some money and walk away. Because they broke as fuck in the spiritual realm, bro. And in this realm. But I was gonna slap her in the face with some money. I was gonna slap her ass down them steps. But she walked away. I be fucking with them. I be trolling them in the dream realm, in the spirit realm. I'd be like, y'all want some money? You want some money, huh? You poor. Because in the dream realm, we be smoking black and miles and shit. Like, everything in the dream realm is free for us. They gotta pay, though. And that's what's coming to the planet. Okay? That's what's about to come to the planet. They gotta pay. We don't. So everything be free for us. Yeah, the eyes is the gateway to the soul, family, and that's why I wear socks all the time. Look, I got a whole bunch of socks, bro. Even when I'm wearing slippers now, I put on socks because the soul can, the soles of your feet are important as well. And it's important for me to keep my feet clean. Like I told you before, I left my house in Akron. I had to purify and clean my feet, keep them clean. I was always doing foot washes and soaking my feet and preparing my feet for the steps I was about to take, because they some big steps I'm about to take. Bringing the kingdom of heaven to earth. So I had to keep my feet clean. So now when I clean my feet, I put on socks to keep them clean. Even better, you know. So it's important to keep your guys' feet clean too. Your feet are very, very important. And there's certain spots on your feet that represent different organs in your body. Like the spot underneath your big toe represents your heart. The next spot over is like the liver. You can find a map of it, of what everything on your foot, every part of your foot represents to the your internal organs. But your feet are very, very important. And they, you said tumbling down. They broke. Yeah, yes, they is. They broke in the physical too. Now tell them about it. Tell them. I done took everything from they dumbasses. I done took everything. They be in the spiritual realm begging, bro. Do not feed the detestable beasts. Don't feed the detestable beasts, okay? There's the detestable beasts and then there's the righteous beasts. Don't feed the detestable beasts, okay? Don't feed the motherfuckers, family. Do not feed they ass, bro. I'm telling you, don't feed them. They deserve this ass whooping. They deserve this shit, bro. They deserve this shit, bro. They deserve it. I be walking around trolling their ass. You want some money? Okay. I be trolling their ass in the dream realm. They can't stand me, bro. They cannot stand me. I be fucking their ass up. And then ask them. I be standing over top of them after I fuck their ass up. You want some money? Good luck to you and that scratch off. A lot of people are buying scratch off. Yeah, buy the $1 billion ones. The ones that say $1 billion, buy them ones too, because them ones got some. Well, actually, I don't know. Listen to what spirit leads you to buy, because a lot of people have won the $1 million off the spiritual. I mean, they have won the $1 million off the $1 billion lottery tickets now. So go big. But let spirit guide you to the ones that you should buy. Okay? Because they've been winning off of them other ones. You know, they only put so many of them out that everybody been winning. Okay? But the winners are out. We are down to the winners. So go to wherever spirit is guiding you to pick them up. Okay? Yeah, but yeah, that magic is on them. They can't stop this. They tried to stop it. They tried to stop it, bro. They tried to stop the lottery magic, and they couldn't. They couldn't. Now that the block is really unblocked, the money block has been unblocked completely, it's over with. It's over with for their ass, bro. I finna fuck this breakfast up, family. Hell yeah. Get that money. Get that money, family. Get that money. Y'all deserve it. Yeah, I can't believe they all the lengths they went through to stop us, bro. That just shows you the amount of fear that they have. And then they still trying. They still trying, bro. They still, but it's not working. Like, we gotta set up to where every time they try and do stuff to us, they doing it to themselves. They fucking themselves up, bro. It's like all we gotta do is sit back and watch now. They fucking themselves up, bro. Trying to fuck us up. They fucking themselves up, bro. We so cold. We didn't set it up to where every time they throw something at us, it don't even bounce off of us. It never leaves them. It never leaves them. They working themselves, bro. And we just sitting back watching like, look at this dumb motherfucker right here. You a dummy. You a dumbass, bro. You dumb. They need to be scared. Yeah, they is. And they think there's a way to where they could come out. And then the people that they would go to, because now they paying for work. Well, they been paying, they didn't spend over $1 million putting work on me, bro. These celebrities, they didn't spend over $1 million putting work on me. And ain't none of it work, bro. So now they're practitioners that they've been going to, like they've been going to different countries having people put work on me, bro. Listen, the practitioners are telling them, it's not gonna work, bro. What are you doing? This person, you're not, this shit is not gonna work. But they don't care. They don't care, bro. They's like, this, it can't be over. It cannot be over. They're in disbelief that I made it through everything. I was supposed to be dead 1 million times over, bro. They put big money on my head, bro. Big money. Big money. We still here. Salute. You made it. You made it. And you about to elevate on their ass and flex. Flex on them. Flex on their ass. These motherfuckers put big money on my head, bro. And lost. Now they losing everything, bro. Everything. Not only do they gotta pay back what they stole, but now they owe more. We my granddad said, we leaving no crumbs. They gotta give everything. Everything? Everything. All these motherfuckers finna be homeless, bro. Homeless. Homeless and desolate. Fucked up and destroyed completely. It's gonna be a beautiful day when Ja Kingdom arrives. A beautiful day, all the enemies are slayed. It's a beautiful day. Yeah, they done dug their own graves, dumb motherfuckers. Yeah, listen, they trying, they don't even know what they doing. They're trying to put work. they finna die. And these practitioners keep telling them, it's not gonna work. They keep telling them, okay, I'll take your money, but I'm trying to tell you, there's nothing you can do. They working they sales, but they think they slick, bro, by going to somebody else. They think that it ain't gonna hit them. No, that shit is coming right at your ass and the motherfucker who kept doing it, even though they knew they shouldn't have been doing it. It's gonna hit them. That's why these practitioners, some of these practitioners is like denying them, like, no, I can't. Some, like, they have to go find new practitioners, for real, because the ones they were, they getting tore up, the ones they was using. They family members is dying, they sick, they fucked up, bro. They fucked. Listen to me, family. All them jars that they was putting us in them, it's creating sinkholes in motherfuckers' yards. they shit caving in, bro. That's why Earth is over there doing. They over there doing, they have to find new practitioners because they keep telling these motherfuckers that it's not gonna work, and they not listening. So they, when one of them say no, they go and they take a couple weeks to find a new one that got a good report. And them motherfuckers is fucking around and finding out right now. So they spending thousands upon thousands. They done racked up over $1 million trying to kill me, bro. And it ain't work. That's how retarded and dumb they are. These people don't make no sense, bro. I just be looking at them like, what the fuck is wrong with y'all? Yeah, we're in the 10th year right now. We just passed the 9th. Now we're working through the 10th year. It's been damn near 10 full years y'all been trying to kill me, bro. And ain't nothing worked. One time, I died, but I woke up. Okay, listen, let me tell y'all. I died, but I woke up. Yeah, girl, I woke up. Okay. She look, listen, hold on, let me show you this lady. Hold on, let me come up out of here. Look, this the lady that walked past me, was like, yeah. And I was like, yeah, girl, I died, but I woke up. She was smiling and shit. She the ops too. She was like, yeah. Okay, I died, but I woke up. I was like, I asked my wife, I said, I died, didn't I? She said, yeah. But that wasn't the first time that happened to me. I remember at the end of 2014, it was sometime in November, The same thing happened. I was sleeping on a park bench. It's crazy. It was in Lihue. And I just remember blacking out and not breathing. But I woke up like 5 minutes later. And I was like, damn, I just died, didn't I? Yeah, you just died. But they can't kill you. I died, but I woke up. I was like, these motherfuckers crazy. The fuck? I warned them too. I've been warning them for years, bro. I keep telling y'all. I keep telling they ass. I can't die, bro. I tried to kill myself, bro, to end this shit. I just woke the fuck back up, bro. My spirit team was like, all you gonna do is fuck yourself up and be in pain and be yelling at us to take away the pain. You need to stop. You're not gonna die. So I stopped trying to kill myself to end this shit. I just wanted it to be over. Like, cause if I ever die, this whole thing ends. Instantly. Everything ends. So I was trying to hurry up and end it by giving myself, because I always knew I was the sacrifice, but I'm a living sacrifice. I'm never supposed to die. And I'm not their sacrifice. I'm the sacrifice for the true ones. I sacrifice my life, like having a regular life. I'm never supposed to die, bro. I've died already and resurrected. I was the first resurrection when I was Osiris. I'm never supposed to die again. These people don't understand that. Yes, tell them something unique. I have risen. Okay. Yeah, but I'm not a sacrifice. They thought I was their sacrifice. I'm not your sacrifice. I'm the true one sacrifice to get them out of. I sacrifice having a regular life. Okay, I was never supposed to die, bro. I already did. And they was trying to kill me so they could take my... They're trying to swap destinies and take all my wealth. And then it got deep. They're trying to kill my baby. They're trying to kill my wife. They're trying to take everything. And then they was like trying to take our essence. Like they took a piece of my soul that I had to regenerate, bro. I had a hole in my soul because of them. And they sold it. And I had to, you can get your soul back. Like you can't take that part that they took back, but you can regenerate. If you keep working and healing yourself, you can regenerate the pieces of your soul that you lost. Okay? It's not forever gone. You just have to work really hard to get it back. And that's why they was playing with my sacral chakra. Now, I told y'all, that's where the soul lives, in the sacral. That's why they kept doing sacral chakra work on me. So, once I've healed, my wife helped me a lot, too. But once I healed enough to bring that part of my soul that they took and sold, I became unstoppable even more. I became even more powerful, and that pissed them off. And then we put up a block to where they couldn't do it no more. Can't nobody play with my sacral no more. Yeah, I give thanks for y'all. They thought I was their sacrifice. The fuck? No, not this time, buddy.
You know on the 500
conference? At 11:30. Yeah, we got about 15 minutes, because I'm about to get on the 500, too.
It's 11:14 right now.
Yeah, we got about 15 minutes. I know you, brother. You from Chicago. I heard you telling your story, right? Ain't you from Chicago?
I talked to you.
You did. I was by you. You was talking to this white lady.
Yeah,
on the bus one day. I was like, this is some bullshit, but they did the same shit to me in 2014.
I know they be asking all kind of questions, like, mm-hmm.
Yeah, but they did the same shit that they did to you, to me, in 2014, and I've been fighting the police ever since.
Bro, shit, I'm on probation right now. I just did 1 year.
You did 1 year probation for that shit?
No. I'm on probation right now, but I did 1 year in jail stabbing niggas up.
Yeah.
These white niggas and these local niggas try to...
They crazy, ain't they? They intimidated by us for some reason. I don't know why, bro.
No. They not intimidated. It's just that...
I want to try you.
I hear that black people are dangerous on the mainland. Yeah. I want to try their ass. So, okay,
yeah,
try me,
that's
bitch.
The intimidation. Yeah. Bye. Yeah, they're fucking them up. But I was fighting the police.
Bro.
They had to put on SWAT gear and come and give me a hard old shot in my butt. There's a whole bunch of them, bro. A whole bunch of them. They came in and rushed me. Yep. I never left the front of the jail. You know the front of the jail where it's the intake, and that's where solitary confinement is? I never left that part of the jail for 2 months, and then they flew me out to Oahu to OCCC.
Oh, but the whole
that shit crazy, ain't over there. But they put me in a hospital over there because they didn't want me around everybody because they knew I'd click out on everybody. So they kept me in a hospital to watch me. But the same shit they did to you, they did to me. And I've been fighting the police ever since.
Damn.
Yeah, but they don't fuck with me like that no more.
I'm going to try to holler at the sick.
Yeah. All
right, bro.
Be well, man.
All
right. Yep. I love y'all, too. Yeah. That's the dude I was telling y'all about in the one live stream where he had, the police had he had beat up somebody by the radio station because they was harassing him. He was in jail stabbing motherfuckers. I'm trying to tell them they intimidated by us for some reason. I don't know why they intimidated by black people here. Well, not I can't say all local people because some of the Hawaiians already know we brothers. They already know what time it is. Maybe because they feel like we the roots. Everybody came from us. And they know that they know that God is black and coming back to they souls and spirits know what's about to happen on this island. It's about to be total divine order. This is where the kingdom of heaven and earth is gonna be at. That's why all these black people is coming here, because they know God is calling them. That we getting ready to do some shit here. All these black people over here now, and they nervous. They feel like they finna lose their position, but we just here to help them get their land back, bro. We finna create balance. Yeah. They nervous. They forgot that we brothers and sisters, bro. And I can't say all the Hawaiians, because, like, the king of Hawaii that lives here, not the one that they say is the king on Oahu. I'm talking about the true king of Hawaii, the Hawaiian kingdom through his bloodline. He lives here on Kauai. I met him. My wife introduced me to him at the movies. We was at the movies one day. She said, "That's the king of Hawaii." Come tell you, everybody knows my wife. Everybody who is important knows who she is, because she's helped them. They don't just know her from her being the role manager for Dead Prez. They know her because of her works. They know her because of what she has done with her life and helping humanity in different ways. Okay, that's why they know her. She introduced me to him because we was at the movies one day. She said, "You know who that is?" I was like, "No." She said, "That's the king of Hawaii. That's the true king of Hawaii in the Hawaiian kingdom." And she introduced us to each other. We was watching. Matter of fact, it was when that movie Descendants came out, that was filmed here in Hawaii. And they got, what's his name? George Clooney in it. And he called himself Papa Holly, but he had all his land here on Kauai too. And he ended up selling it. And they was like, "Don't sell the land, because all they gonna do is sell it to Walmart and all that." That was like a kind of like a documentary in a way. But they filmed part of that movie Descendants here on this island, and me and my wife went to go watch it. And then the king of Hawaii happened to be there with his wife, and they was like, "What, Nash?" They was happy to see my wife, and my wife was like, "Hey," because my wife, she Brooklyn all the way. Okay, they were like, okay, they love her accent. She Brooklyn all the way. So she was like, "You know who this is?" And she introduced me to the king. So what's up, man?
Can you watch this for later?
Yeah, bro, I'll be here till the bus comes.
What time the bus comes?
At 11:30. So you still got like 10 minutes, bro.
Yeah, 10 minutes.
Yep. Sorry, I'll be
bro.
Here.
All
right, yep. Yeah, so she had introduced us, bro. And people think that this one dude that be in all the movies saying that he the true king of Hawaii, he be on Hawaii 5-0. But he live on Oahu. He is not the real king. The real king live here, and they know it. He's like a decoy to the king. But everybody know the true king is here. And then on top of that, I'm the true king. I'm the king of kings. But through his bloodline, he's the king of Hawaii right now. You know, it's the whole thing about the Hawaiians fighting for their land right now, and for the Hawaiian kingdom, for the monarch to be reestablished. And me and this guy where I'm staying right now, his name is Martin. I don't know, you might have heard me talk to him before in one of my lives. But me and Martin be talking all the time about the Hawaiian kingdom and what's going on, and how people have falsely occupied this land and stuff. We talk all the time about everything, and how a lot of the people, the Hawaiian royalty, what go to school in England and stuff. That's how they made their connections. That's why the British flag is a part of the Hawaiian flag, because the Hawaiians at ancient times used to go, well, not even super ancient times, like a few hundred years back before this land was stolen from them. They used to go to the United Kingdom and get their, well, to Britain, Great Britain, and get their education. The Hawaiians were educated in Great Britain. That's why the British flag is on the Hawaiian flag. They have a deep connection because the Hawaiian elite will take boats over to Great Britain and get educated. They're not stupid people. They're very smart. And you know that Hawaii was one of the first places to have electricity because of that relationship that was established with Great Britain, and how the Hawaiian elite, the royalty, would go there to get educated. So they would meet people like Thomas Edison and shit like that. And that's why Hawaii was one of the first places to get electricity. So, yeah, the relationship is deep with Great Britain. And then here come America. We was talking about how in 1992 or 1993, Bill Clinton was like, we know we stole your land. What are you going to do about it? He just apologized. Bill Clinton just apologized for stealing the Hawaiian land. But he didn't give it back. But he admitted that it was stolen in an apology letter. He made a big deal about it. All the cameras was there recording it. And he apologized to the Hawaiians for stealing their shit. But didn't give it back. That pissed off the Hawaiians real bad. And ever since then, they've been fighting and going through genealogy. And they all related. They're all related. Like, so all y'all is still royalty. Yeah, y'all just fighting over who sits on the throne now. They all fight each other, too, over whose time it is to sit on the throne. Just like we fighting over who's the great mother and great father right now. But there's no fight because y'all not doing nothing. Me and my wife is doing. Y'all just talking. The same. This is some nigga shit. This is what my wife used to say. My wife said, there's lava niggas, there's sand niggas, and then there's the black niggas. She said, we all niggas. Look at how they act. Over here, over here is the lava niggas. Over there in the desert is the sand niggas. Okay? We all niggas. You still a nigga. Why is we fighting each other? But it's because people are disrespectful and shit do need to be corrected, okay? Tradition need to be corrected, and that's one thing I don't like about Weiss's wisdom. She's saying there's not a hierarchy or a rank. Yes, there is, and there will forever be a hierarchy and rank, because motherfuckers need to know their place. Because when y'all tried to take away the rank and the hierarchy, look what happened to the world. Everybody has their own seat to sit on, their own position. Go sit on that shit. That's why there is a rank and a hierarchy, motherfuckers. You gotta understand that and respect it. There is a divine order. Just by her saying that, she's trying to take away divine order. Just by her saying, there's no rank or hierarchy. Yes, that's divine order, bitch. Just get in line. But these motherfuckers don't like that. Because they trying to sit everywhere they don't belong. Okay? Isis wisdom is crazy, bro. Something wrong with that bitch. She need to go sit somewhere for a long time. Bitch, keep burying yourself in that sand till you're dead. Okay? Stay in that sand, bitch. Don't come back out like a sand turtle or sand crab, bitch. Stay in that bitch like a sand crab. Bury yourself deeper. Deeper and deeper, ho. Keep burying yourself till your head is covered. We don't need you around. You cause too much confusion and you lie too much, bitch. You lie way too much, Isis Wisdom. You lie way too much, girl. You cannot cleanse nobody's karma. My bus finna come. Let me see if this is it. This might be the 400. Let me see. I'm waiting for the 500, the Hanalei bus. I'm finna go smash this food like I ain't never ate in my life. Let me see. Oh, it's the 100. It's the leave me. He's going to the airport. Okay. We got a little bit of time. Yep, in about 3 minutes, I'm getting off of here because it'll be 1 hour and my bus should be here by then. Or at least on its way, because it come at... What are you, motherfucker? It come at 30 after. But yeah, I love y'all. Yeah, order is very necessary. That's because she knows she ain't got no rank. She over there lying like a mother. Then everybody all like, Flareborn. Flareborn is an op. Okay, that bitch is artificial intelligence. That's not the truth at all. Flareborn is crazy. She might have a little piece of the truth and then she be over there lying about everything else. Flareborn is a government clone. These motherfuckers be like, oh, Flareborn shit. Flareborn is Willy Wonka, you dumb motherfuckers. Okay? She be talking, because her code for the government is Willy Wonka. That girl is Willy Wonka, okay? That's her. Yeah, so you can finally be born outside of the Omniverse and be the source that you always been trying to be. You gotta learn these lessons and earn these stripes first. People be moving too fast. But yeah, Flareborn and Ops, bro. I told y'all, everybody on 363 is the Ops. The only person who not is Sister Myra L. She was the only one. But some of her shit was flawed too. But she the only one who was trying to stay true. That's it. A bunch of weirdos. These people crazy. Crazy, crazy. Everybody else that come on there? Yeah, she called the government Willy Wonka. She the Willy Wonka. You crazy as fuck, bitch. All up in the chocolate factory. Swimming in the motherfucking chocolate pool. Eating the giant gummy bears and lollipops, playing with the Oompa Loompas, rolling motherfuckers out that look like giant blueberries. That's her, Willy Wonka. She crazy. Flareborn is not to be trusted. Yeah, man. Sister Myra is trying her best to stay true. Okay. A couple of things she said I didn't like, but I understand where she got that teaching from. She got it from Bobby Hemmett. That's her teacher. And not everything Bobby said was the truth. That's why he had a stroke. People think people put a hit out. Bobby was attacked by spirits that he was trying to have sex with. And Bobby was doing some weird shit. Let me just put it at that. And he was combining spirits that don't fuck with each other. Look, it's a 9-6 flip in the chat. Bobby was trying to, Bobby was working with spirits and trying to make spirits that don't fuck with each other, fuck with each other, bro. Bobby was doing a lot. Once he learned his power, yeah, that comes from some of her teachings that Bobby taught her. But she definitely...
Thank you.
You're welcome, bro. She definitely got some knowledge, and she not trying to steer nobody in the wrong direction. She just going off behind the shit that she learned from Bobby. And I'm trying to tell y'all that everything Bobby was teaching was good. That's why he had that stroke. But yeah, the bus about to come in like 2 minutes, so I'm going to get out of here, but I'm definitely going to connect with y'all again soon. Like I told y'all, when I move into my new place, I'm going to show y'all. So, as always, peace to the true ones. I love y'all. Sending y'all positive energy, love, strength, endurance, and great power. Do y'all thing. Keep flexing on them, family. See y'all soon.